given to the best performing states like Tamil Nadu. Coming to the GST, it has been implemented more than a year ago. The country has to understand the impact of implementation of the GST in India over the last 1 year. I would like to point out that Tamil Nadu has been one of the best performers after introducing the GST. But there is going to be a significant shortfall in the settlement amounts due to Tamil Nadu under the new GST regime. I request the government to consider and rectify the aberrations. Coming to the bills, we are here that the Ministry of HRD has prepared a draft bill for setting up of higher education commissions, replacing the old age university grant commission. The government of Tamil Nadu is of the view that the existing institutional arrangement of the UGC with the regulatory and financial power is functioning quite well. So, and as such, there is no need to disband the university grant commission by replacing it with the higher education commission. In the proposed bill, the financial powers are supposed to be transferred to the Ministry of HRD. All of us have been apprehensive in this regard. So we oppose the proposed bill and feel that the present framework of university grant commission should be allowed to continue. We also hear from the government that it proposes bringing dam safety bill, which was approved by the Union Cabinet on 13/6/2018. This House may recall that a similar bill was introduced during the UPA regime in 2010. That bill was objected by the then Chief Minister, Honorable Dr. Jayalalitha. Fortunately, it did not see the light of the day. Now, the present draft dam safety bill is violating the rights of Tamil Nadu. In this regard, the Tamil Nadu Assembly had adopted a unanimous resolution on 26/6/2018 that urged the central government to take up the legislation only after consulting the states. The resolution also urges us still